So far, we've taken care of the head, but now it's time to take care of the body. Let's go back to our mark file test, and this is what we currently have. For testing purposes, I'm going to go ahead and add one more line on here so that we can rest assured that we're getting the correct data back. I'm going to add an H1 heading, and I'm just going to make it heading. And that's it. I just want to make sure that we are getting back the exact data that we are expecting. Back in our press file parser test, let's write a new test. This test is going to be the body gets saved and trimmed. In this test, we're making sure that very similarly to the head, in that data array, we have an entry for body. So I will actually copy this prep and put it here. And we are making sure that we have a body. And now what should be here? Now at first glance, that might be a little tricky, but let's go back to our markfile1.md and see what we're really expecting. So we're expecting this, and then we are expecting one line break and another line break, and then we are expecting this. Okay, one line break, two line breaks, and then that. However, we've already learned that using single quotes will not work because it gives us the literal backslash n as opposed to a new line. So let's switch this over to a double quote. Okay, let's run our test. Back in the terminal, PHP unit, dash dash filter, and we get undefined indexed body. Okay, let's get to work. In our press file parser, we are currently not really doing anything here in terms of saving the body. Even though we have the full strength of this data, we are not doing anything to actually save the body. And I'm going to show you. I'm going to die and dump this data right here. And let's see what we get. If we looked at the string under key 2, we actually see that we have that already. However, we are not saving it. So let's go ahead and save it. This data, and then we know that this is supposed to be body, and we're going to set that equal to this data at key 2. Again, key 2 is this key here, and we're getting this. Let's see what happens now. Okay, in this view is a little tricky to see, so what I actually want to show you is this. I'm going to die and dump this data key 2. So we have some leading new lines that we were not expecting. Just like we did with the head, we can trim this string and get the proper results we need. Let's take a look at that. Okay, there we go. Let's change our code. Instead of this data, we're going to pass in trim this data key 2. And there we go. We're on a green test. In the next episode, I want to tackle parsing that markdown into actual HTML.